Hey guys, what's up? As I said in my previous vlog that there is a long journey that is awaited. We were supposed to go on the bike, but it's been raining cats and dogs and I can't take my wife on the bike for 6 hours, especially in rains. If the climate was good, then we would have ridden down, but then because of these rains, it is difficult to, you know, sit as a pillion for 6 hours in drenching riding gear, and a wet riding gear is not very healthy also. So we are going by car to Gokarna. See you in a bit.
So getting out of our great city of smart city of Belgaum took us almost 15 to 20 minutes with its crazy amazing off-road adventures, and we pretty much have rain continuously all throughout. It's cool, so the engine is also cold. I mean, good fuel efficiency, good average speeds. At least on these roads I try to maintain good average speeds, because once I reach Dharwad, it's all single lane. So now we are on the Hubli-Dharwad bypass, and I am taking the vehicle to a side because there was a very impatient Xylo guy desperately wanting to overtake. So I just let him go because I was in no hurry. This is one road that needs to be converted to 4-lane because it holds up traffic like crazy and reduces your average speed. Once we got off the Dharwad bypass, we merge onto the Kalkadgi road, and this road is a narrower single lane. It goes all the way to Yellapur and Sirsi, and then it goes to Ankola on one side. So that is a road that we have to take all the way to Gokarna. Just there is a small junction before going to Ankola, so we'll be taking a left. The roads are beautiful. This road actually reminds me of the NH4 before it was converted into a 4-lane, before it was made into a golden quadrilateral. So the National Highway 4 from Belgaum to Bangalore was exactly like this, with trees on both sides, and you could literally pack your lunch and stop wherever you want. Entering the town of Kalkadgi was chaos because traffic left, right and center, people going this way and that way, crossing anywhere, cattle also. So just got to be a bit careful when you're driving through villages, especially on this stretch, because these villages are, you know, they'll not think twice before thrashing you, even if you know hit the dogs or the cattle on the road. Mob violence. After Kalkadgi, the roads get better, a bit wider also, very scenic, very beautiful, and there is a small ghat also, which is not very good, but it is smooth. It doesn't have huge potholes like Chorla or Amboli have. So it was a very fun drive with continuous drizzle and rain all throughout, and this was a very small patch where actually we didn't have much rain, but throughout we were having heavy rain, actually very heavy rain and moderate traffic. This is the ghat, very small ghat. So this is nothing very enthusiastic about this ghat, like not very smooth roads, but not bad roads either. But you just got to be careful for oncoming traffic and people who overtake on blind curves. So you have to actually be very careful, not just careful, but very careful. So this ghat is just after Yellapur, and yeah, as you see, people just want to overtake even on blind corners. So it's a trait in India. That's why I prefer driving in the night, especially on ghats. Driving in the night is very safe. The views here are mind-blowing. There is another destination that we visited after Gokarna, that is Jogue Falls. So we took the Kumta to Jogue Falls route, and that road is mind-blowing. The views there are crazy. I personally have driven more than 4 lakh kilometers, at least more than 3 lakh kilometers on Indian roads, and I have yet to come across such smooth ghat roads. The road didn't have any kind of jerks, nothing. So that video will follow after this on the next episode of our travel diaries. Stay subscribed to the channel to get notified about that video also. As you can see, it's been raining and raining, and there is gravel in a few places on the road, so just got to be a bit careful. But more or less, it was a fun, enthusiastic drive all the way. And thanks to Google for, you know, showing these roads on maps, because there are some crazy roads that people have to experience actually. Deep forests on both sides, literally deep jungles on both sides. We actually spotted a deer on one of these roads, and unfortunately the camera was off. We also wanted to visit Yana Caves on the way to Gokarna, but unfortunately we realized that by the time we reach the caves, it'll be late afternoon, and since we had not had anything for lunch, I doubted we would get anything there, and also it was raining heavily, so we wouldn't be even able to enjoy these caves. So Yana Caves is a destination reserved for my next trip, hopefully on the bike. Let's see. You can see these crazy views everywhere on this road. and it has started pouring again and pouring like crazy. There are crazy views everywhere. More than driving on the Golden Quadrilateral or the four lane roads, if you enjoy driving or riding, it's more fun to ride or drive on these roads than the four lanes. It's more adventurous also. So just before the road goes towards Ankola, there is a small left which I couldn't find, I couldn't see, but the map was telling me to take a left. It was a very small road which I couldn't see. So, and I didn't realize that this road is very important, because if I would have missed that left, then I have to go all the way to Ankola and come back to Gokarna. But I was also skeptical if the road was actually ready, because everyone has seen jokes about Google taking you places and getting you stuck. Recently there was some tourist from Germany who landed up in the fields in Rajasthan just because Google Maps took them there, saying that there's a road. So there is a left here which I missed, that I was talking about, because if you see closely, the road is not visible. It is visible, but I was not, it was not so easy to see, so I had to take a U-turn on the highway and quickly went on that road. And that road was an adventure in itself, scary as hell because no traffic at all, and I was worried I would get stuck somewhere without any phone network. But what a crazy road it was. I mean, you had a river on one side or a lake on one side, and all farms and fields on the other side, and a small hill on the other side. Beautiful views. We in fact stopped at one point just to stretch our legs and enjoy the scenery. So this road is basically a shortcut. It goes and joins the road coming from Ankola towards Gokarna. A very narrow road, difficult for 2 4-wheelers to pass. We'll be right back. this scary bridge with just mud. I was just imagining if the bridge was not there, because the bridge was relatively newly built and you can see mud to the approach to the bridge is not constructed actually, just mud, and that mud has been flattened. Also, this place is just 30-40 kilometers away from Gokarna, but it nowhere gave me the feel that I'm about to reach the sea, because the because of the climate, because of the surroundings. It is completely different. I mean, it looks, it doesn't look any like anything that is close to the sea. So this was the place where we stopped to stretch our legs, a small lake with some boats and a beautiful view. I stopped, I took it slow and allowed them to pass, because it doesn't make sense splashing water on them. I know people enjoy splashing water, but it's not good. So our little adventurous road ends here, and we join the 4-lane coming in from Ankola. This goes all the way to Kumta and Murdeshwar and south. But sadly, we had to get off this road in like a kilometer or two, because Gokarna again is on the other side of hills. We're off the highway and onto the road that goes into Gokarna. Water on both sides, beautiful, peaceful, but there was no place to park to enjoy the view and you know, stretch my legs. So I just kept going. Gokarna is actually a small town which is in the hills, and that we have to climb these hills which give beautiful views like this, crazy views. there are quite a few viewpoints, but I was scared to stop because there was traffic and fast moving traffic everywhere. इसलिए मैं किधर रुका नहीं. I just stopped for a minute or two and we left. So getting down onto this private road is actually the road that goes to our resort. Its name is Aarti Gamya Resort. Very economical. I think it was around 3,000 rupees per night. And we booked for 2 nights, but we suddenly changed our plans and thought of going to Jog. So we stayed here for a night, and the next video will be about Jog Falls, the drive to Jog Falls and our visit there. So as of now, let's watch this. This resort is very close to the beach, Kudle Beach if I'm not wrong. Yeah. So we checked into our rooms, and there is a small pathway that goes below the resort, actually from the side of the resort, and it takes us to the beach directly. But because of the rains, if you see, the pathway is flooded with water. Not flooded, but there is continuously moving water. And I was pretty disappointed with the beach because I have never seen a beach in this condition. So my wife was having troubles, so this is the circus she did. So the beach is right up ahead, and it was the worst beach that I've ever seen. I never expected a beach to be so dirty with all garbage. And the reason why we came to this beach was because we were hungry and we had not had anything apart from our breakfast, and unfortunately nothing on the beach was open. All the establishments on the right are small cafes which were all closed either due to COVID or due to the monsoon, so I couldn't figure it out. So what we did was we just went back to our rooms, had a quick lunch, ordered from the restaurant there, and left to Om Beach. So we had to park the car very close to the beach and just walk down. There is a cafe called Namaste Cafe which we intended to go to after spending some time on the beach. So we walked down to the beach, and you can see the crazy views that this beach has. I literally spent quite a long time just watching the water hit the rocks on this beach. Making full use of the extended selfie stick of the Insta360. That feet extends to around 8 feet or more, if I'm not wrong, 8 feet or 11 feet. It gives a drone-like view. can spend hours and hours on this beach without realizing how time is being spent. It's so serene and peaceful and calm, and you will never get tired of watching the water hitting the rocks. So here's a short time lapse for you guys. It's not a time lapse, it's a slow motion video which I could record on the Insta360. After spending some time on the beach, we entered Namaste Cafe, but the attitude of the manager, the guy handling things there, was a bit rude, so we didn't bother to wait there and we left, and we reached another famous cafe called Mantra Cafe to spend the evening, and we spent some good time, but then I couldn't record anything because it was already getting dark by the time we went in and sat and found our table. It was already getting dark. This cafe has got some crazy views. The food is average, but the views are crazy. So after Mantra Cafe, we went back to our rooms, and the next day was a big adventure. Stay safe, stay subscribed, and wait for my next video, because that video has got some crazy, crazy epic clips and views coming.